Good morning and welcome to this webinar. My name is Marietje Smit and I'm the Chief Education Specialist at MPOC. Today we're going to discuss the PAT Waiter task and I just want to give a few seconds for everybody to join the webinar. Okay, let's get started. Once again, my name is Marietje Smit. I'm the Chief Education Specialist at MPOC for Hospitality Studies. And before we start with this webinar, I just want to welcome you to this webinar and I hope you're going to learn a lot today and all your questions will be answered. I also want to go through a few basic things for the webinar so that you know exactly how you can be assisted through this webinar. So first of all, if you can't hear me, please turn up your volume so that you can hear me. You will be automatically muted when the session begins. Should you have any questions, you can make use of the raise your hand in your box or the question box. You can also write your questions there if you want to ask a question during this session. Then you will also find all this information in the question box and remember to send us your questions. If you don't want to ask questions during this webinar, you can ask questions after the session. Attendees are encouraged to ask questions and leave comments. However, irrelevant or inappropriate comments will result in an attendee being dismissed from the session. If we did not get to your question, please send us an email and we will help you with the question. And then all the answers of the question during the session will be sent to you. And if you don't get it, you can just ask or send an email to info@impact.co.za for us to send it to you. And then I just want to remind you about the MPOC YouTube channel, where you can get all the recordings of this session and also the previous sessions. Okay, let's get started. Today, we're going to look at the PAT Waiter task. And just for your information, there's two tasks. So the waiter consists of a task 12.1, the written preparation, which counts 25%, and then also your task 12.2, the practical part, which counts 75%. And you may do both PATs on one day. That means your chef task, which we discussed in the previous webinar, and the waiter that we're going to discuss today on one day if it is arranged with the assessor, or you can arrange to do the chef task on one day and then the waiter task on another day. It's all between you and the assessor. Then just quick again, the assessment methods for this PAT. We did discuss it in the previous webinar also. You can make use of the MPOC assessment and also a private assessment. With the MPOC assessment, we do all the arrangements. We will send you an email with all the information and also an email address where you can send your proof of payment to book your space. This payment is for the parents or the guidance accounts and it's paid to MPOC. And then the assessors present at this assessment will write their registration number on the barcoded cover for MPOC to accept the marks. And just take note that there's always limited space because we use the kitchens of schools through the country. Then with the private assessment, learners make all the arrangement with the assessor. If you want to find a new assessor, we do have a list. Or if you want to approve an assessor, you can just send an email to this email address and they will help you. This payment is also for the parents and the guidance account, and it is a private arrangement between the two parties. That means that MPOC has nothing to do with this, so it's between the assessor and the parents. Also, the assessor must write down the registration number on the barcoded page for MPOC to accept the marks. And then for grade 10 and 11, the assessor will mark both tasks. It means that they will mark the written task and also the practical task for both PATs, the chef and the waiter. Okay, just a quick overview of the planned PAT dates for 2020. You will see that the first one is on 23rd of May in Western Cape. We will send out information about this. At the moment, we don't have permission to go off with this assessment. So as soon as we have more information about the lockdown and it's possible, then we will send you an email with all the information. And just a quick overview of the requirements for the assessor too. We did discuss it in the previous webinar. For grade 10 to 12, just take note, 10 to 12. So there's no exceptions for grade 10 and 11. It's the same requirements for 10 to 12. Appropriate qualification in the study field. The person must have 3 years experience in teaching grade 12. This is not in a tutor center, but in a school where there is moderation. Done by Sakai IEB or Sakai IEB or DBE. And then this can't be a chef, so it must be a teacher, and therefore they must have a SAIS number. So that's the requirements for the assessor. Okay, let's look at the first task, and that is the 12.1, the written preparation. I just want to mention that this is a very important part of the PAT. A lot of kids don't take this seriously, and then they lose a lot of marks. So please complete this properly so that you get 25 out of 25 if possible, so that you can do well in your PAT. Okay, the first page of your preparation forms to complete is this one. And I will just go through it quickly to help you a little bit and give examples of what we expect from you. So if you look at the first, let's look at this side first. So this is more or less what we expect from you for 25 marks. Please make sure that you include everything when you submit your task and don't lose unnecessary marks. Okay, so the first one that you need to fill in is your name, your student number, and your center name. Please complete this. A lot of kids leave this out. Just make sure that you complete it properly, this forms. Then a very important is your menu. Now for grade 11, this is your prescribed menu, and you have to rewrite it there, or you can print it and paste it there. It doesn't matter as long as you have your menu here. We actually prefer that you write it so that we can see if you know the rules for writing out a menu. And then just next to it, we expect from you to indicate the serving time for each course. So in this case, we will have the hors d'oeuvres first, then the potage, that's the soup. So let's say, for example, the hors d'oeuvres will be served 7 o'clock. And then the next, this is just an example, so it's not according to your menu. So let's say the next course will be potage, that's the soup. So the soup will be served in 19:30. Then your main course will be served 8 o'clock, and then your dessert will be served 9 o'clock. So please take note of this. I did write it here for you. We normally allow a half an hour per course, but for a main course, we will allow an hour because they have a lot of food to eat for the main course. So that's why I said 7 o'clock, 7:30, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, and then the tea will be served after that. Okay, so that's actually very easy to get your marks there. And then this description at the bottom is very important because the waiter needs to know what dishes can people be allergic to and what is the ingredients in the dishes that people can be allergic to. So we, in the past, we gave the recipes for the menu, but now we expect from you to do some research. Let's say get 2 or 3 recipes of the hors d'oeuvres, 2 or 3 recipes of the soup, and then you can more or less see what ingredients are in the soup or in the hors d'oeuvres. And what the people can be allergic to. So if the guests arrive at your restaurant and they ask you, what is this dish or this dish, then you can explain to them so that they know exactly what it consists of and what they must be careful for, especially when they are allergic to something. And in this case, a full description must be given. There's the example. So say, for example, it's a soup, then a thin, clear, but very tasty soup made with chicken stock. So that's important, especially in some of the religion groups. The stock is very important to know, and then they won't be allowed to eat that. And then we don't want you to write the gluten. In this case, let's say it's flour used in a recipe, or there is like milk used, then we don't want you to write lactose. We just want you to write milk. You can do lactose in brackets if you want to, or flour in, and gluten in brackets if you want to, but we want the flour and we want the milk, the ingredient that the people can be possibly allergic to. Okay, so that's your menu. Then the second page is your planning. Now, planning means it is before the guests arrive. So that is everything that you need to do before you start laying your table and before the guests arrive at the restaurant. So this is just a short example, and it's not done in full, but you can, it's just an example for you to know what you must write there. So it's just a short planning for yourself so that you can't forget anything during the practical. So let's say, for example, your time will be 3 hours in total here, or maybe 2 hours for the the part where the guests arrive, but an hour or so before the function. So let's say you do 6 o'clock, you do your mise en place. That will be things like moving your tables in position, opening the windows, switching on the aircon or the music, sweeping the floors, etc. And then take out all your apparatus, fold your napkins, polish your cutlery, steam your glasses, fill your milk jugs. All those things must be done. So there's still a lot of things that you can write there, but I just mentioned a few examples there. So this will help you a lot during the pat so that you don't forget anything. And then let's say, for example, the guests arrive at 1900, then just before that, we will start lighting the candles, and just before the guests arrive, we will take the cocktail drinks to the reception where there will be a table or whatever where we will put the drinks for them to use when they come there. So just take note, this planning is for everything that needs to be done before the guests arrive. So it's very easy, and this will help you a lot when you do it properly. Okay, the second one is a labeled diagram of one cover, and that is a complete set for one person. Please make or take note that some of the kids, they draw the whole table, and that's not correct. We only draw one set place per person or for one guest. And in this case, it will be entree, your soup, your main course, your dessert, and then your white and red wine with your underplate, your serviette, and then don't forget about your side plate and your butter knife. Just make sure everything must be in one line here, 2.5 centimeters from the side of the table. Okay, and then also remember to label the diagram. A lot of kids don't do that, and then they lose more or less half of the marks if it's not correct. Okay, then we do the opening mise en place. To fill in this part of the form, it's actually also very easy. Type and a quantity of cutlery that you're going to need for one cover. So in this case, we will have, for example, one entree knife. But if we serve, and this will be completed according to the number of the guests. So in your case, you will serve 4 to 6 guests, and then one is for the cover for one person. And if there's 4 people, then you will have 4. And let's say we serve 50 people at the function, then that will be 50 entree knives. So you just multiply it by the amount of guests that you are going to serve. This is a list for the storeman to help you to take all the apparatus out and to make sure that you have everything before you start laying your table. Okay, so you will do the rest for the other courses. And then for the serving, the bread, the tea, the coffee, and the crumbing down, you have to write down everything needed for serving. Don't forget something. So let's go through it quickly. The tea and coffee service will include your cups, your saucers, your doily, your teaspoon, your milk jugs, your sugar bowls, your sugar spoons, your coffee pot, your side plate for the coffee pot, your serviette for the coffee pot, which we discussed in a grade 12 previous webinar for coffee service. So make sure that you have everything there. Then your serving utensils for the bread. This will include your bread basket, your serviette, your dessert spoon and fork, because we will use silver service to serve the bread, or you can use a futon. And then also don't forget about your butter and your butter knife. And then for the crumbing down, this will include your dessert spoon and dessert fork for the silver service, the serviette which will be folded in a triangle, and then also your side plate that will be used for the crumbing down after the main course. Okay, then we will look at the glasses. Most of the kids, they do bring with water glasses and champagne glasses, and I don't know what glasses they bring, a lot of glasses, but it's not necessary. You can only bring a white wine and a red wine glass, and that will be enough for the table. And we can always put a white wine and a red wine glass on the table. And then In this first column, you need to write, for example, 4 white wine glasses, because that's what you need for the table. And then also remember to mention the type of beverage that you're going to serve, not white wine here, because white wine doesn't mean anything. So we will just want to check if you can see what type of wine will go with the menu. So let's say 4 white wine glasses, then you will say, for example, Chardonnay or Stein or whatever, because that's white wine, types of white wine. And then this one is very important, the third column. This is where you write all the extra items that needs to be on the table. A lot of kids forget to lay the sugar, the salt and pepper on the table. They forget the toothpicks. They forget the serviette sometimes. So just make sure that you write everything here so that you don't forget it. And things like tablecloth, your table number, your menu, your serviettes, runner or your overlay, everything must be mentioned here. And you can also specify the tablecloth, for example, red round tablecloth or triangle black tablecloth, so that you know exactly what you're going to need for the function. Okay. Then the layout, you can decide on your own design, or you can draw it as it is, as the, for example, the room or the restaurant where you are going to do your path. If you don't know, then you make up your own design. So in this case, please make sure it's 3 marks that is earned very easily. If you do it properly, make sure that you have an entrance there, because that's the things that we look at when we allocate the marks. So do you have an entrance? I do have one. We have toilets. We do have toilets, chair and a table. There's your chair and your table. And please label your guest, your sketch, because it's important for us to see what did you include in your layout. And then there's the buffet, the bar, etc. So you're in that's all what we expect from you. Yeah, so it's not that difficult. Make sure that you do that properly also. Okay, then the guest list, also very easy to earn 2 points there, or 2 marks. A lot of kids don't fill in the function and the date, and also the waiters' names. Please make sure that you fill it in completely. And it's actually very easy, because you just mention any function's name there. You can also write their pet, but try to do something else like matric farewell or 21st birthday or wedding or something, because it will be a formal function. And then 23 May, not Afrikaans, but English. So sorry for that mistake there. And then your guests 4, 4, 4. You can only write 1 table if you want to, or you can just complete all 3 tables. It doesn't matter. So yeah, then you earn your 2 marks here. Okay, as you can see, you can earn a lot of marks here if you just do it properly. So yeah, make use of this opportunity to improve your PAT marks. Okay, and then the bill. The bill can be filled in at home also, because it's part of your preparation. And you can use any examples here, any prizes, it doesn't matter. So in this case, we will have the table number. You can choose your own number. You have to write your name there, the waiter, and then also the clients. So in this case, you will serve 4 people. So that will be 4, or there can be 5 or 6. It all depends on how many covers you lay. And then my examples was 1 times Coke, R12.50, 1 times water, R10, 2 times Sprite at R15 each. Just make sure, a lot of kids make a mistake here. If 2 people order Sprite, then multiply it by 2. Otherwise, you will lose some profit at the end of the month. And then also add up correctly and get the total. We are not asking you to do the tips and so on in this bill, because that will be decided on at the end of the function, and you are completing this before the function. This is just for us to see, because you don't have guests, just for us to see that you can complete a bill during your PAT. So that is the practical of the preparation, or the written preparation. And as I said, you can have a lot of marks here if you just do it completely. Okay, so I will allow questions now. If there's any questions, Serena, she's also helping me with the questions. So if there's any questions, we can answer it now, please.
There is one in the question box. It's asking, should you name the color of the tablecloth?
Yes, in your preparation, you can mention it. It's better because if you want to take it out or you give it to the storeman, and then they know exactly that you need a round red tablecloth or a black triangle tablecloth. So it's better to mention the color, yeah.
Okay. And then is the guest list and the bill in the pad?
Yes, everything is in the task, in the written task.
Okay, that's the only questions I can see at this stage in the question box.
Okay, thank you. And we can now go on to task 12.2, the practical. Okay, I just want to go through the general guidelines. A lot of kids and parents don't read through this, but this is very important information. So I just want to take a minute or two to go through this. First of all, your preparation task is done before you go to the PAT day and do your practical. So no late preparations will be accepted after the PAT. So let's say, for example, you use the MPAC assessment and that's on the 23rd of May. Then you need to complete these preparations beforehand and then submit it on that day. When you sign in, then you give it to us and then we will mark it and submit the marks. So no late preparations will be accepted afterwards. Also, the assessors, they're not allowed to take preparations afterwards, so it must be done before the PAT. And then the bill of the drinks must be fully completed by learners, learners' own examples and prizes. We did discuss it in the previous slide. And then learners must be properly dressed according to the requirements indicated in the task. I have a slide about that, so we will just discuss it now. And then learners must use the prescribed menu and set the table accordingly for at least 4 to 6 guests. At least 4. I know there's some of the assessors that allow only 1 cover. It's not correct. They must lay the table for 4 people. And they must use our prescribed menu. And I will just discuss that in a slide or two from here. Okay, then apparatus are supplied by the learners themselves, unless others stated otherwise. So for example, if you use a private assessor, the arrangement will be between you and the assessor. It depends on the venue that you're going to use. But if it's an MPAC assessment, we will send all the information in the email that we send out because we use different venues in different provinces. And if it's a school where they have hospitality, most of the apparatus are available, but you're also allowed to bring your own stuff. But just make sure of the information in the PAT, send it to you. And then learners should bring their own tray, serving cloth, etc. It's more or less the same as the previous point. And then learners must use the prescribed dishes and design their own menu for the table and also their own table number. I will discuss it a bit later. Okay, then photos must be taken as prescribed in the task. Just remember, and I ask the assessors if some of them are joining us for this webinar, please help the learner because it is the responsibility of the learner, but they can't take photos of themselves while they're busy laying the table. So if the assessor have more than one kid to assess, then some of the other learners can also help with the photos. Please make sure it stays the responsibility of, remains the responsibility of the learner, but please make sure that you do get all the photos. And please take note, if there's no photos in the task, MPAC will not accept the marks because that's one of the requirements and there must be photos. So please make sure that you add the photos when we ask the tasks for moderation. Assessors will assign each learner a number for identification, especially where there's more than one learner at a time. And this is especially when MPAC do the assessment. So then we will use the photos and the marks according to that number that we assigned to you. Then assessment, for example, the serving of the coffee, the serving of the wine, the crumbling down, etc., will be done via role play. Now that means that there will no guests be present. And we will ask you to tell us and explain what you are doing. So, for example, if you serve the coffee, you will tell us, "I'm putting the I'm placing the sauces and the cup on the table with the ear to the right side. The teaspoon must be placed underneath the ear on the right hand side. And you must explain this while you're doing it because there's no guest, but as if you are serving guests." You will explain and show with the apparatus. And please take note that you can't do it without apparatus. There must be a coffee pot in your hand when you serve coffee. Otherwise, we can't see on the photos what you are doing. So please make sure that you have all the apparatus that is necessary. There is a list in the study note of all the apparatus that you need for the chef and for the waiter pad in your study notes, which you can download from my MPAC. So make sure that you have all the apparatus needed for this pad. No eating and drinking will be allowed. No learners will be leaving the examination room before the assessor give permission. And please, no persons other than the grade 10 and 11 learners will be allowed. So these three rules is the same as a final examination rooms rules, and no one else will be accepted in the rooms. So no parents, no tutors, only the assessor and the learner, and no boyfriends and no friends or whatever. So only the person which do the assessment and the learner will be present in the examination room. And then the last point here is that for the assessments, both of them, that means that we will assess the chef and the waiter. And in MPAC's case, if we do MPAC assessments through the country, we will charge you 750 for both tasks, and that means it's 325 rand each, 375 then for each. And then we will assess both of them. So that's the going rate, more or less. And private assessors are not working for MPAC, so they can charge anything they like, but we are giving the going rate of 750. So please make sure that they don't charge you 5,000 and 2,000, because we did have cases like that in the past. If you do have a case like that, please let me know so that we can talk to that assessors. So that is the general guidelines, very important for the PAT. Then when it's the day of the PAT, you must bring the following. First of all, your barcoded task covers, which you can download from my MPAC. For both PAT tasks, that will be for your chef, task 11.1, 11.2, and then also for your waiter, 12.1 and 12.2. The mark sheets for both PAT tasks, you must also bring that with. That is for 11.2 and for 12.2. You will also fetch or see that in the PAT tasks. And then the photos will be taken during the PAT practical on that PAT day, not before the time, but on the PAT day. Then you also have to bring your own cover for the menu, and it looks like this. So let's say, for example, you choose a theme, black, white, red, roses, that's your color scheme, and also you want to use roses, then you will make the menu's cover according to your theme. So you have to choose your own theme, and just remember that this must be a formal theme. And then the inside must still be your prescribed recipe, which we gave you in the first slides that we discussed today. So you can't choose your own stuff and or your own dishes. And also take note of this very important thing is a lot of kids, when they come to the practical, they put the dishes that they are going to cook for the chef pad in the menu, and that's not correct. This is actually two separate functions. And you have to use the recipes or the dishes that we prescribe in your menu in the task. So task 11 and task 12 is two different functions and not the same. So please don't write in grade 11 you do the apple pies and the apple pies, and you can't put the apple pies in there for dessert. So you have to use our prescribed recipe. Please make sure of that. Oh, sorry. And then your table number, I did discuss that now, and your own table decoration, very important, because we don't have this at the schools or at the venues. And then also correct clothing as prescribed in the task is very important. So that brings me to the next slide. Just a few photos on the waiter uniform. We do describe this in your tasks. For the boys, it's actually very easy. This one is very neatly dressed. Also, the hair are very neatly, the nails, the shoes are clean, and the clothes are correct. And then for the girls, you can have either a skirt or a shorter skirt. It's also correct. and then a pants, pants that you can you can wear. So please make note of, please take note of this, the hair there, that's not 100% correct, but make sure that everything is tied neatly and that nothing can fall into the food of the guests. So make sure of that, please. Then just once again, this is your prescribed menu. So you will see, I did discuss it in previous slides, very important that you use this prescribed menu as in the task, and that you do some research on the dishes in the menu, because we can ask you what is risotto, what is tangy tomato soup, what is panna cotta, what is meringues. So all these things we can ask you during the patch, so that you can explain it to us. Okay, and then I want to go through the mark sheet just to help you, so that you can see what will be assessed on that day. So first of all, we will look at your personal appearance. So that's very easy to get your four marks. Make sure you have everything correct there according to the guidelines and to the prescribed clothing in the TOS, and then you can get four marks there. Then we will look at your opening mise en place. That includes your tablecloth overlay, your napkins. Is it folded correctly and neatly? Is all the items on the cover at the correct place and spacing? Is everything clean and shiny? A lot of kids don't do this before the patch, so they lose already two marks there. And then, do you have all the things on your table, all the extra items like the table number, the menu, the salt and pepper, the flowers, etc.? So that's 18 marks there. Then we will also look at the communication. How do you handle the guests and how do you communicate with the assessor? In this case, there won't be guests, so it will only be the assessor. Can you describe and explain each course like I discussed in the previous slides? And then also your body language, what does it tell us? And also, how do you welcome your guests when they arrive at the restaurant, and also when they leave? How do you communicate with them? So that's very important. Then we will look at the service and the cleaning of beverages. So in this case, it will be the wine and the coffee. How do you take the orders? How do you remove unused wine glasses? How do you serve the coffee? And how do you open and serve the wine? So that's everything included in this point number four. And then we will also look at all the courses. How do you serve it and how do you clear it? So it means clearing and carrying away empty plates, crumbling down after the main course. When do you do it? How do you do that? And also the bread service. So all those services and cleaning we will look at for all the courses. And then the last two points that we're going to look at, are you professional? Are you functional? Do you start on time? Do you listen to the assessor? Do you work as a team, especially when we use other schools' venues? And at the end, do you help us to clean and leave the place as we got it from the first in the first place? And do you help and offer your help to the assessor? So that's also very important to do. And then at the end, is everything packed away, and also your ingredients and the apparatus that we use at the school. So that's more or less things that will be assessed on the pad day. Then if we look at the photos, which are very important, like I said, if we don't have photos, there's no evidence that this happened, so we will not accept your marks. So first of all, we want to see in the photo what's going on there. So this one is your mise en place. This one is, you can see this learner is serving bread. So you can see if you just stand with your hand like that, with no apparatus in your hand and nothing here, we can't see what you're doing. So we want you to have apparatus in your hand while you're doing this and explaining to the assessor what you are doing. Then we look at the bill. Do you have sweeties and a pen and toothpicks and everything in there? Is it covered or is it in the side plate, folded? Then we look at the crumbling down. We look at the wine service. We look at the cover. So we need a photo of the cover so that we can see if you lay the table correctly, and also the spacing. You can also take a photo of the whole table like this, but the laid table, so that we can see how the whole table look. And then clearing the plates, coffee service here, and then also a full body photo of the waiter. So that's very important, the photos. Okay, then I'm gonna close this webinar with the lockdown, just information about that. I do have a lot of inquiries about this. The pack doesn't count for the term marks, and therefore we still have time to do this. The assessment plan that you have and the dates, the submitted dates there, is just a recommendation according to the Sakai subject guidelines. So in this case, we are able to take the PATs until just before the November examination. So there's no need to be worried at this stage. So my recommendation to you at this stage will be to please complete the written preparations in the meantime for the CHEF. That means task 11.1 and also 12.1, and keep it with you. So then that's done. And then in the meantime, you can practice your dishes, your apple pies, and also your laying of the table. And then you can practice that a lot this year. We have a lot of time with the lockdown. So they say practice makes perfect. I just want to mention that some of the kids, they come to the PAT, and this is your final cooking and waiter PAT, and then they don't even read through the recipes. Don't do that to yourself. Please practice it at least once or twice before you come to the PAT. And then still, an approved assessor must assess this. I do have parents and tutors now at the moment which are worrying about the lockdown and the PATs, and they want the parents to assess and they want the tutors to assess. This is not allowed. If there is a problem and we are running out of time, we will give you a solution on the PATs, but at the moment there's no problem and no need to worry. So just do the written preparations in the meantime, and then we can do the practicals, which is task 11.2 and 12.2 later this year. And then MPAC will, at the end of the lockdown, if it's necessary and we need more opportunities, like more opportunities, as the dates that we discussed earlier in this webinar, we will organize more opportunities for all the learners so that we can help them to get the PAT assessed. This is just for my side. If there's any questions about the PAT or anything about this webinar, I think, Serena, we can answer the questions now, or you are allowed to send me an email so that I can answer your questions, please.
There's just two more questions. The first one is how to handle if you're having a private assessor with regards to the virus. Can you ask the assessor if he or she has tested without being rude, or how can you handle that situation?
I think at the moment we must leave the practical part and just see what happens. So we don't have the answers for this. I think, yeah, that's a difficult question, but I think if it's not necessary, don't go to an assessor, don't let the assessor come to you at the moment. There will be still time to do that after the lockdown. So I will recommend that we start doing the preparations and then later on do the practical assessment. So there's no need to worry at this stage, like I said in the slide. So I think that will be my answer for that question.
And then the last question is the prescribed menu in the grade 11 task?
Yes, the menu is in the task in 12.2. So you will get it in 12.2 and 12.1 to complete the preparation forms.
Okay, that's the only questions at this stage.
Okay, thank you, Serena. Okay, then we're done with this session. If you want any extra information, you can contact info@impact.co.za. And then I want to thank you for the joining this webinar. If there's any questions or concerns, please email me and talk to me so that I can assist. And yeah, good luck, and practice makes perfect, like I said. And then we will inform you if there's any changes in the PAT situation after the lockdown. Thank you.